Hello and welcome to this video talking about key 802.11be transmitter measurements with Keysight's test software called Pulsewave Axial-Risk Measurement Applications. 802.11be, also known as Wi-Fi 7 or Extremely High Throughput, is the next generation wireless LAN building on 802.11ax. The main objectives are maximum throughput of at least 30 Gbps per second per access point, carrier frequency operation in 2.4, 5 and 6 GHz bands, while ensuring backwards compatibility and coexistence with legacy Wi-Fi compliant devices. To meet the need for extremely high throughput, new and enhanced physical layer features are introduced compared to 802.11ax. These features include 320 MHz contiguous bandwidth, doubling the peak throughput, 4096 call modulation, enabling a 20% increase in data rates, enhanced OFDMA, allowing multiple resource unit assignments to a single station, making the resource more flexible and efficient. Finally, up to 16 spatial streams doubling spectral efficiency. The combination of these features provides a maximum theoretical data rate of 46 gigabits per second. For RF measurements, the impacts of these features are much higher than previous generation Wi-Fi. One of the key RF measurement challenges is signal quality measurement of high-order modulation formats of a wide bandwidth. Error vector magnitude, or called EVM, is a key metric used to evaluate the signal quality of a transmitter. Wide bandwidth systems contribute to higher EVM as they have more integrated noise and more variation in flatness and linearity. With high-order modulation formats, the spacing between the constellation points become much more smaller, making the system more sensitive to impairments. So, it requires more stringent EVM performance. And IEEE standard has a transmitter EVM specification of -38 dB for the 4096 QAM. To minimize the measurement error, test equipment must have a much lower EVM floor. To overcome this, Keysight provides a high-performance signal generation and analysis solution. For this demo, I will use Keysight Signal Studio software for waveform creation and the Axial-Risk application software for signal analysis. These software are used with Keysight Signal Generator and Signal Analyzer platforms. For illustration purpose, I will use center frequency at 7 GHz in this demo. In Signal Studio, pick multi-user PPDU frame structure with 320 MHz bandwidth. The MU PPDU is used for both single-user and multi-user transmission. Here, turn off the compression mode for multi-user transmission. We'll use MCS13 for the highest modulation format for 4096 QAM modulation. Generate the signal and export waveform. In Pulsewave signal generator, record the waveform file and do instrument nonlinear calibration based on waveform to give accurate test result. Enable RF output with center frequency at 7 GHz. Let's now analyze the signal using XAPP. Here we can see the spectrum at 7 GHz frequency. I'll go to the wireless LAN application and select 320 MHz 802.11be signal. All other configurations are changed to auto detect. The XAPP decodes the sig field in the preamble and demodulates the signal automatically. No further setting is required. XApp provides fast view display for different results. In IQ Polygraph view, you can see the 4096 column in the constellation diagram. Here is error summary showing EVM and other error metrics. The EVM limit for the 4096 column is -38 dB. Here, -48 dB resulting at 10 dB margin. This high of a margin gives you the confidence and what's being measured is the true performance of the device under test and not of the test equipment. In burst sig info view, it demodulates and decodes each sign fields. From the universal sig field result table, we see physical version identified is 0, which means radio standard is 11BE. PPDU format is EHT multi-user, preamble CRC passed, bandwidth is 320 MHz. PPDU type and compress mode is downlink OFDMA. Radio link is downlink. Everything decodes correct here. The user info view provides a per-user performance result, includes resource unit size, power and EVM per user. In this case, there are 5 users. All users' modulation format is 4096 com with MCS 13. As we know, there are 2 sections in EHT sig field. They are common and user-specific. Here, station ID and coding format can be decoded in user field table. Common field table gives guard interval size and CRC pattern results. XApp provides results view customization as well. You can combine results window you are interested in one view and save it for fast results display. Here we combine constellation diagram, error summary, user info summary, USIG info table, EHTSIG common and user specific table in one view called decode view. We can get all interested information quickly next time. For equalization and tracking, all the default settings are as defined by the IEEE standard. For example, the equalizer is trained using the sequence and data. It will further improve the EVM results. Equalization does not compensate for nonlinear errors. XApp provides measurements such as EVM vs carrier and EVM vs symbol to help troubleshoot any problem in the transmitted signal. Optimized EVM method is provided here as well to give you accurate measurement. In addition to modulation quality measurements, the IEEE 802.11 specification has spectral emission mask or SEM requirements. It is mainly a measure of interference within the Wi-Fi band. The XApp provides this measurement with a quick setup and fast bit by enabling wideband IF for FFT. Here you can see the spectrum with SEM limit mask. For each offset, the SEM power table returns the measured absolute and relative power. Here SEM measurement is passed. Let's move on to a quick uplink demo, which is trigger-based PPDU with preamble puncturing. From the spectrum, you can see the 996-tone puncture pattern here, defined by IEEE 11BE standard. XApp provides recall IU allocation file when IU allocation setting is triggered to menu. Here we recall uplink IU allocation file. In burst and the sig info table, decoded result is correct here. Bandwidth is 320 MHz. PPDU type and compress mode is uplink OFDMA. PPDU format is trigger based. In this example, a single station is assigned to a resource of 996 tones with punctured subchannels, and the rest of the channel is occupied by other stations. Power and EVM for the unused tones are measured in unused tone arrow view based on IEEE standard. This allows you to easily evaluate the uplink signal quality. Next, let's take a look at 802.11be MIMO case running on Keysight's transceiver wireless test set. In Signal Studio, P PPDU format is EHT-MU PPDU, bandwidth 320 MHz, downlink OFDMA with transmit antenna number 2. Spatial mapping is direct mapping here, generate the signal and export waveform. Here we can see there are two waveforms are generated. In XApp, go to WLAN MIMO modulation analysis, config source port at first, record the waveform to ARB memory, then goes to input-output section, config waveform to source and set source RF output center frequency at 7 GHz, output power minus 10 dB. Here, we need to pay attention. We should ensure two-port waveforms are in the same folder. ARB state and modulation will be automatically on after selecting the waveform. Next, let's do source sync. Pick 2x2 MIMO, select transceiver 1 as primary window. Press 6 dot after hardware configuration done. As we can see, source sync is correct now. Transceiver 2 is in secondary mode now. After source configuration, let's config analyzer's port. Pick MIMO type 2x2, set radio standard, and config channel 2 analyzer connection. In stream IQ point of view, you can see the 4096 QORM in the constellation diagram and EVM information for different channels. Here is minus 45 dB, minus 46 dB, both are nearly 7 dB margin to limit. In BirdSeq info view, radio link is downlink, bandwidth is 320 MHz, PPDU is EHTMU. Physical version identifier is 0, which means radio standard is 802.11be. PPDU type and compress mode is downlink OFDMA. BSS color 5. Each sign field information is decoded correctly. In user info view, there are 9 users with station ID from 1039 to 1047 with code format LDPC. In channel results summary, XApp provides sync correlation is nearly 2-1, which means perfect correlation. In channel metrics view, results shows perfect direct mapping, what we want. You can get frequency response and equalizer response for each stream of different channels here. In summary, the XApp provides a comprehensive set of tools for demodulation and signal analysis. These tools enable you to measure and troubleshoot your 802.11be chipsets components and devices with confidence. To learn more and to download a free trial, visit us at these websites.